In this lecture, we're going to take a look at the terms associated with loss. Managers want to sell items for the full retail price to maximize profit. However, sometimes they must mark down the prices of slow-moving or discontinued items to move them out of the store. But marking prices down reduces the profit of an item, and it may even result in a loss, depending on the amount of markdown. Here are some important terms dealing with loss. It can be a reduced net profit, a break-even profit, operating loss, or an absolute loss. And let's take a closer look at what each one of these terms actually means. So here's how the original selling price is derived. The cost plus the added operating expenses plus the added profit. A reduced net profit occurs when an item is marked down from the original price but is still sold for more than the break-even point. A break-even point is a selling price that covers just the cost of the item plus the associated overhead, including operating expenses. A company neither makes nor loses money on an item sold at the break-even point. And the formula for the break-even point is cost plus operating expenses. When an operating loss occurs, the selling price of an item is below the break-even point, but above the cost of the item. To find operating loss, we'll take the break-even point and subtract the reduced selling price from it. The last kind of loss is called the absolute loss, or gross loss. This occurs if the selling price is less than the actual cost paid for the item. For example, a firm that buys a pair of slacks for $38 and then sells the slacks for $25 has an absolute loss, which is the difference between the two of them, 38 minus 25, or $13. Let's take a look at the review of terms. If the selling price lands here, we have a break-even point. If the selling price lands here, an absolute loss. Selling price here, operating loss, and a reduced profit is a reduced net profit. Let's take a look at a couple of examples. Appliance Giant paid $400 for an energy-efficient refrigerator. If operating expenses are 30% of cost and the refrigerator is sold for $500, find the amount of profit or loss. So let's lay out this graph representing the original selling price and identify the information given. The company or business paid $400, that's the cost. They're telling us that the operating expenses are 30% of cost, so we'll take 400 times 30%, which is $120. If we add cost plus operating expenses together, we have the break-even point. They're telling us that they sold the refrigerator, though, for $500. That is falling here, less than the break-even point, and it is at an operating loss. And if we take our 520 break-even point and subtract the sale price, they have an operating loss of $20. Pep Boys Automotive paid $208.50 for a pickup truck bedliner. The original selling price was $291.90, but this was marked down 35%. If operating expenses are 28% of cost, find the operating loss and the absolute loss. So here we have the makeup of the original selling price. The cost was given as $208.50. They are telling us that the operating expenses are 28% of the cost. So 28% times the cost gives us $58.38. Knowing those two values, cost and operating expenses, we can add them together to find the break-even point. And here we have this on our graph. Next, we can determine what the sale price is. They've taken the original sale price and marked it down 35%. There's a 35% discount or savings, which means a customer is paying the complement 65% of the original selling price. So here we have the selling price times 65% gives us the sale price. Where is the $189.74 falling? It is under the cost that this business paid for it. So to find the operating loss, we're going to take the break-even point and subtract the reduced selling price. We determined our break-even point to be $266.88. Subtract the sales price gives us an operating loss of $77.14. And since the sale price is under cost, we have an absolute loss. And to calculate an absolute loss, we'll take the cost minus the reduced selling price, which means we're taking $208.50 minus the sales price, an absolute loss of $18.76 for this problem. In this next problem, we're given the cost of $50. We're given a break-even point. If we're given the break-even point and the cost, we can take the difference between the two to derive the operating expense. So break-even point 66 minus $50, the cost, gives us an operating expense of $16. They're telling us that the reduced price is $44. That $44 reduced price is falling here. We can find the operating loss by taking the break-even point minus the selling price will give us our operating loss. So $66 break-even point minus the reduced sales price gives us an operating loss of $22. And since that reduced price is cutting into the cost, we do have an absolute cost, which is found by taking the cost minus the reduced selling price. We have a $6 absolute loss selling this under the cost that the business paid for the item. One last problem, we're given a cost and operating expense along with operating loss and asked to fill in three values there. So using our original selling price graphic here, we have the cost. We're given operating expenses. To find break-even point, you add cost plus operating expenses, so we have a break-even point. We're given an operating loss. An operating loss is found by taking the break-even point minus the reduced selling price. Well, we don't have that. That's what we're looking for. But we can switch around operating loss and reduced selling price and take the break-even point minus the operating loss will give us the reduced price. Now that we have the reduced price and can see its location is under cost, less than the cost of this item, we can now find the absolute value by taking the formula cost minus reduced selling price to give us an absolute loss of $16.